We would now request our Shikshika ma'am to please present the bouquet to Mr. Naga Kiran as a token of love and respect. Please give a huge round of applause.
I would like to introduce myself. My name is Kiran and I work for the Developer Relations team in India. Welcome to all the guests. Thank you, Ali, for coming so far. Thank you so much. Before we actually talk about what's the Indian community been up to in the last 2 years and what we need to do to go in the right direction to inspire more and more people coming into the Salesforce community, I would like to know how many of us are actually in the community right now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, around 60 to 70% of us. Okay. So how many of us are from the SIs in India? Accenture, Cognizant. Okay, so we are all pretty regular to the meetups. Do we attend the meetups? Okay. By telling you all that India Dreamin is a reflection, it's a celebration of our hard work. Right? It's all our hard work put together in the last 5 years. What results is JDF 17, and 6 months later it's India getting much bigger than the JDF 17. Right? When I started off with working with the community in India, it was comparatively smaller. The engagement was pretty low when, by the time we came in. We had a few inspiring personalities in the community like Gaurav, Ankit, Shiv, who have really worked hard and got through their way of becoming MVPs and serving the community. These 2 years have learned that it's not easy to really contribute to the community, right?
Day-to-day jobs, and we have these meetups after that, and we plan a lot of things. We need to mentor people, we need to guide people in the community. It's not easy. And all these 30,000 community people in India have done a tremendous job. A big round of applause to all of you. Right? So, just coming, we help them, guide them, do stuff. We also work with the WIT, we work with the user groups, we work with the developer groups. We see what they want and what help they need from us as a team in India because we are on the ground. That is one part of what we do as a team. We also go to students because students are the future community for us at the end of the day. We go to students, we go to colleges, we do these Trailhead workshops for 4 to 5 days. We show them how powerful the Salesforce community is and how we need to leverage Salesforce community to build their careers in Salesforce and give it back to the community, right? This is a whole process which happens in a cycle. This is the second thing that we do as a team. And the third very important thing that we do is we work with the system integrators. System integrators are the Accentures, TCSs, Wipros, the big SIs which implement Salesforce for their projects. See, we work with them, we see what are the best practices, we have some developer groups internally in these companies, and we see how we can connect these three circles, the SIs, the community and the students, to build a powerful ecosystem. And trust me, it is happening. It is really happening, and India Dreamin is a reflection of that. Right? The whole community has come together. Congratulations, Shiv and team, for doing it. A big round of applause for Shiv. And it is not driving here. It needs a lot of coordination. It's like months of hard work. Okay? But by making any, please don't go by it. Please go by the official statements that are made. So what are the, what is the present state of Indian community? What are the key highlights of Indian community? Three of the five. Right? It's not a small feat to be achieved. Bangalore, Hyderabad, Pune, Jaipur, and Chennai, Delhi, they're coming up. There are more and more people joining the developer groups. They're seeing what the power is, right? and we have the largest student community in the world for sure. Right? The future is really bright. The future is really bright for us because we see a lot of students already joining the community. We run developer groups for students to actually nurture them and guide them to their successful careers in sales. Right? WIT is very close to my heart. A special appreciation, a special regards to Radhika. Radhika, please stand up and take this appreciation from everybody. She has really been talking about WIT in India. She's been talking at World Tour. She is a big inspiration to all the women in technology in India. I think there are other girls along with her. Right now, Sheeta is there. I think a big round of applause to Sheeta. She's been really working hard in the community in India. And we need more and more people like them. I think there's Neetu Bansal, there is Salma, there is Ritika Bhargava. There are a lot of people, I don't know. I think Salma is there. Please stand up, Salma. Please stand up. It is very important, we increase the women in our community because they definitely have a bright future, right? I think they are the top players for the community in WIT in India. They have been doing these meetups and they are trying to get in more people into their community. I'll maybe give you 5 minutes, Salma and Radhika. You can come here and talk, Shita, and you can appeal to the community for more people to join the community, okay?
Awesome.
Thanks. It's never been before in India like this. See, to host a big event, you need more people coming there, right? So you need to have that confidence that people are going to respond to what you're doing. And all this hard work is paid off, and as a result of that, we have 2 mega events in the last 6 months. It's not small. We have around 1,000 people attending the event in JDF 17, and I think around 2,000 today. I'll definitely see 2,000 today by the people that I see on the floors here. It's like, it's a reflection of how united the community in India is, and it's a result of that hard work. and fantastic engagement on social media. It's like India Dreaming, for example, if you take India Dreaming, there are thousands of tweets. There are thousands of tweets, and these tweets are coming from different parts of India. It's not like only the Noida group is doing, or Shiv is doing, or Daysworks is doing here. The whole country, the whole community in India has united together to make this event a big success, because we are celebrating other success. It's not just our success, we are celebrating the whole community success. And that's the whole purpose of community, to understand each other, to help each other, and to give it back to the community, right? And this is like big. We constitute to more than 25% of the, it's 1/4 of the total community in the world. And definitely we are really doing a great job at that. Energy. But how can we actually channelize that power? How can we really get it into meaningful things in the days to come, right? And so this I found this quote today morning, and I wanted to put it on the slide. If you want to go fast, go alone. But if you want to go far, go together. Right? It really makes very good sense. See, as a community, we are together, and it's not a sprint; it's a marathon. It is a marathon. Trust me. It's not easy. It's not easy to build a community. We have all done it, and we have to sustain that growth and momentum. And we have really got a lot of days work in front of us. Interested in the user groups and developer groups in India? Most of us? Okay. How many of us are frequent visitors to these meetups? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, we should do a better job at it. I would request all of us to be more engaging at this, because our developer group meetups need more audience, right? That is how we can collaborate with each other. Okay. My suggestions to the developer group leaders, the WIT leaders and stuff, there are a lot of good things happening, but how can we channelize this energy? How can we put it into a meaningful direction? How can we have it in the right direction? The first thing that comes to my mind is, have some cross-BUG meetups to know more about each other, right? There's a lot of difference in culture, there's a cultural change, different people doing different stuff all over the world. So how can we have this cross-meetup? For example, I've just given an example there, it need not be that combination, but it might be the Bay Area meetup group versus the Bangalore, right? We can find out a common place, common platform, meet virtually. Okay, have some speakers on this side, have some speakers on that side, collaborate with each other, have some sessions, and get to know more about each other. Because what this does is benefits us a lot in the future to come, right? We can collaborate more on a global basis. Community is not what identified with a single country or a region. It is global. We all are community. So this is one suggestion that I've given our WIT leaders and the DT leaders, and it would be great to have this. And another thing is, we have different DUGs in India, right? We have a Java DUG, we have a Google DUG, we have a .NET DUG. We have developer groups for different platforms. How we can collaborate with different platforms? How we can tell them that this is what we're doing in Salesforce, and how we can know that they are doing this stuff in their platform and appreciate each other. Okay, maybe build an integration with Salesforce and Java application. Maybe give a session. Maybe know maybe know more about each other. Because what happens is, when we do an event like this and we have collaboration with other platforms, just imagine the number of audience you would get for this event. Just imagine, it would triple, double, multiply the audience, because they know what you're doing, they connected with you as a community, and that is when they will be more interested to come to these mega events, right? This is one thing. And what about grooming the next, right? We really worked hard, we have gelled all the people together in this community, but how about building leaders for the next generation, right? You have to make leaders. Nobody is a born leader. It comes out of experience. It comes out of skill. It comes out of hard work. It comes out of crisis situations. So how are you going to groom leaders for the next generation? I think the DG leaders and the UG leaders in India should also look at grooming the next people in the community. Okay? Empowering them with a lot of stuff and making them do this type of stuff. And this has always been in my mind. We have been doing tons of great workshops in India. These are the circles of success for me. The community, students and SIs. And when these three circles of success come together, it's a very powerful ecosystem we have in front of us. Very powerful ecosystem. And we have around 30,000 community members in India. Can each of us guide one student, mentor one student? It's not tough. It's not tough at all. Trust me. We are building our own community. We are building our own community. We are guiding somebody. At the end of the day, it's a lot of satisfaction before we see. We are guiding their careers, right? We should think in those lines. We should channelize this power. There's a lot of energy and power in our community. We should channelize this in the right direction. And these are some things which have come to my mind in the last 2 weeks. I've been really busy with the Trailhead workshops. I was sitting for the last 2 weeks and thinking, we have come a long way. We have come a long way together and we are seeing some great things happening in front of us. And we need to move in these directions. These are some of the ideas I've got in my mind. I'm quite sure we have better ideas than these, but we have to start thinking in these lines to make it a better place for us, right? Ground root level in India. We've gone to the colleges. We have started talking about our Salesforce platform in these colleges. So these are some people I want to really appreciate. Vinay Chaturvedi, big round of applause to Vinay. Because I'll tell you how India Dreaming started. Vinay and I have done a workshop in GL Bajaj 6 months back. And that is when we got this idea to do a big community meeting. And it was a big success here. And Gaurav Ketrapal, a big round of applause to Gaurav, because Gaurav has been extensively working with us in enabling students, talking about Salesforce platform. How can they build their careers in Salesforce platform in future? And Radhika, as I told you, Radhika has actually conducted 2 workshops already in 2 engineering colleges recently, and she has been spreading the word really well, really well. I think we have to take a lot of inspiration from these guys. And this, trust me, this energy is contagious. See, when you see some people doing it, there is some success coming out of it, you will definitely have a lot of people taking inspiration from it. And Kishore. So Kishore and I have already done one workshop there, we've spread the word. And there's another workshop that we are planning in the next 2 weeks in Indian Institute of Sciences in Bangalore. That's a very prestigious institution. So just wanted to let you know about people who are doing some ground root level stuff in India in the community. Okay, this is very close to my heart. I've been working with the WIT leaders in the last 1 year. We had a lot of summits. And trust me, I think they are really useful to the community. They are the torchbearers, right? They have led the way from the front. We have invited them to our Salesforce office in Hyderabad, Hali. We had a very meaningful discussion for the whole day. What made us meet them is their passion and motivation to really bring up women in India. It's not easy. Culture in India is different. Traditions in India are different. We see the society in a different way here. So we are trying to break those rules. We are trying to encourage more and more women in the society. They have a lot of challenges in their day-to-day life. We were discussing a lot about them. We are seeing how we can overcome these challenges in India and really make them successful. Because there's a huge population of women in India who are like really doing well in technology. We want them to come to the community, right? So it's like both men and women put together makes a successful community. It is not about a single gender, and that is what we really strongly believe in as Salesforce, right? I'm really looking forward for a lot of suggestions for our leaders here in the community. What is working for you in other regions? What is not working here? I will open up this forum for questions if you have any questions, and I'll be more than happy to answer them. Any questions you might have? You want to join the community? You want to contribute? You want to know what are the prospects of it? You have a question? Smiling?
I think it's very hard to ask the first question.
Okay.
So I would like to go first.
Yeah, please. You've always taken up the initiative.
But you gave us 3 good suggestions, like cross-culture,
yeah,
cross-platform, going to the root level, and educating students.
Yeah.
tell us more on the educating students part and student mentorship. So, for me, I have started in the WIT Leader, a student mentorship program.
Okay.
In which every professional who came in my meetup was and every student who came was assigned a professional. And we worked with, we gave them five first trailheads and then worked with them for more trailheads. And that is how they are progressing. So is there any official thing or as anyone can join you in a student mentorship or any way?
See, we are already one family in the community. Guys, so she's the first one to initiate mentoring students in Pune, and she's doing it successfully with her team. She has a team of very efficient girls who are really working with students, going to the colleges, spreading the awareness. And see, the main hook in India for a student is a job. That is how they look at a platform. Will this platform give me a job? Will this platform give me a monetary benefit for us? So that is where Salesforce future in India as a career comes into picture. It's very critical for them. So what we do is we go to students, we tell them that this platform can give them a better career. And that is how we start off. That is how Radhika starts off. You have a lot of jobs in Salesforce. Interestingly, Salesforce has a lot of demand in India, but lesser resources. It's the opposite of other technologies in India. So that is a situation we really need to tackle. We need to go to students, inspire them, talk to them about technologies, especially girls, right? Because you're doing with girls, right? And so when you show them that this is really beneficial to their career, that is when they start showing interest, right? That is when they start showing interest. And that is when we have a very big advantage over other platforms. We have a free learning environment, which is Trailhead. No other platform in the world has a free learning environment. So that is where you can show the student that this is a self-learning interactive tool through which you can learn A to Z of Trailhead and make your career, right? It doesn't stop at basic badges, it goes to projects, it goes to modules, it goes to super badges, and it's like, doesn't happen, right?
And what's the like win-win situation? Do you offer any projects for them or any internships?
See, Rajvi did for the students. Please welcome Rajvi onto the stage. Rajvi, ex-developer relations in India. So we have started off this new initiative, Holly, I forgot to tell you in our discussion yesterday. So we are shortlisting some students, right, on small pro bono projects, right? Do you want to talk more about it?
Yeah. It's still a pilot. So good morning, everyone. So thanks again for coming to India Dreamin on Dushera. And we are really excited to be here to answer the specific question. So we are actually working with an NGO in Hyderabad. You know, so Salesforce has been associated with this NGO for a long time. So they are basically helping kids who have hearing and speech disability. So, and this NGO has a production Salesforce instance, right? So we are trying to see, you know, how we can leverage students who have done 100 plus badges to manage this production or and also, you know, be associated with Salesforce team in Hyderabad, with the R&D team. You know, we are working with Sriram, who is basically heading that team, and also our team, so that they get imbibed into the Salesforce structure, they work on a live environment. At the same time, you know, they get exposure to something beyond Trailhead. You know, while Trailhead is great, but, you know, any learning platform has limitations. Trailhead is built for scalability, but are doing 100 badges enough? Sometimes they are not, because you need a real experience. So that is where our initiative comes into picture. But this initiative is still in the proposal stage, but something like this will come. And you know, what we are trying to say is that you can also start a similar initiative. Say for example, Accenture might have tied up with some issue, right? Or if there is a non-profit work you are doing, and there is a production or work, you can get, give a chance to see. So the whole point is that unless they get hooked into a professional environment, it's very hard for the kids to understand, you know, how corporate world college man. And this is a small initiative we have started. Hopefully we'll make it big. And you know, I just wanted to throw this idea at you guys as well, so that you think, start thinking the same. over to them.
Thank you, Rajiv. Thank you so much. Shashank works for our team developer relations. He's a great evangelist for Salesforce. We've been doing it for the last 3 years. So we started off this initiative for freshers in SIs. Right, they get hired in process. So we are trying to include Salesforce in the event. Shashank, you want to talk more about it?
Thank you. Hello everybody, how are you going? I'm proud of what we achieved, and we're also very excited about the new initiative that we're coming up with. One of them being taking Trailhead into this large audience of students who were almost ready for business skills, but they just need that little push, right? So Trailhead has that scale and power to do that. And my job as part of this initiative, along with my team, is to make sure we take it to all these organizations which hire a lot of freshers, not just colleges, we go to college studies, but they also hire a lot of freshers from various institutions, right? You know that, right? Infosys, Wipro, Accenture, all of the biggies, and the medium sized ones, all of them. So they hire hundreds and hundreds of freshers. It's a great opportunity to make them learn about Salesforce and benefit from what it has to offer for their careers. And Trailhead is a free and fun platform for that. Right. So we are hoping to make this a big success, and any support from the community is always welcome. Please feel free to reach out to me anytime. Thank you so much, Kiran, for the...
Yeah. So the reason why I called Rajdeep and Shashank is we might get more ideas out of this. Somebody was raising their hand there. Do you have a question?
And that helps me a lot to gain knowledge of Salesforce platform. And also, I have done one application replicating the library management system for okay. College. I'm trying to plan my four-year final project on this platform.
Okay.
So I had a great help from the community, but to be frank, we are not able to have the exact plan of what to start and when to start the project.
Okay.
We are good with the platform, and also we are having some applications being built on it.
Okay.
But it's small friend that we have Salesforce started, right?
Right.
Absolutely.
So just to give the audience a background of who Yashwant is, MBGR is one of our most successful ventures when we were doing this year, Satyanarayan Reddy, who has done a great job with us in mentoring the students. Right? Yashwant, it's a great question. It is about mentoring people from students from colleges. I think you come into that category, we will definitely get in touch with you and see how we can help you go further in this.
So I'm running a small organization in Ahmedabad. So till now, I have given a training to 10 plus freshers.
Okay.
So
great.
We have given them job after training.
Awesome.
So I would like to ask you, is there any kind of data available like this? This kind of students are having knowledge about Salesforce, they have done Trailhead.
Okay.
Right? So, can we get those data so we can approach them for this kind of further training so that they can get a real experience?
Absolutely. I think that is where
we are facing, as a small organization, we are facing this challenge.
Okay.
Whenever we require resources like this, so we are not able to get them.
Awesome.
Because they might not, in our area, the students are not having that much knowledge on Salesforce, and they are not aware about Salesforce jobs and all.
Yeah. So, Yashwant, you brought your video on students who have really done
sure.
Well on our
sure.
And looking for opportunity.
Sure. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Currently, I am working with software and technologies.
Okay.
And I am a freelancer trainer in a school also.
Okay.
So, first, my question is that I have seen that many freshers who are means they have done very hard heads. They have a very good knowledge, and still, if I am talking about Hyderabad, Mumbai, Pune, there are some opportunities for freshers even in Jaipur, as people is from Ahmedabad, I've seen. But why we have very less companies who are just taking freshers? NCR reason. Because I've seen that there are freshers who are very good in technical knowledge. Even I have trained them. having a 2 years experience person also.
Right.
Is what the people are in the industry.
Right.
Why we are having a result? The first question is that. And one more question is that. As we see, we have a lot of projects from UK and US. Okay. All the mid-sized companies, they have using Salesforce. What is the reason why in our country, we say India, the SMEs are not using, they are using other CRMs rather than Salesforce.
Right.
It is the cost factor, it is the use. What is the reason? And even I am having 10 years of experience, and BTEC is from IIT Lucknow, that is good college, from the triple IITs.
Okay.
Even I have seen my friends even don't know means what Salesforce is.
Hmm.
So what is the reason why we, and how will we scope up with these things?
Awesome. I'll start off with the first question. I think your first question was, we have seen this problem. There are few companies who do their core implementation of Salesforce. You see, towards south, it's like in Bangalore, Hyderabad, some in Pune. I think Bangalore, Hyderabad and Pune give you the chunk of job opportunities. I think it's mostly, and Jaipur has a thriving ecosystem. Jaipur has got a lot of job opportunities. I think Salesforce, Salesforce startups culture has really grown up in Jaipur. It's really good in Jaipur. I think mainly because tech jobs are mostly concentrated in Hyderabad and Bangalore. That is one reason why you don't have as many jobs as we expect in NCR region. That is one question. And I think we should also encourage people to move to other regions for the jobs. Right? See, start the initial parts of your career, I think you should be willing to, because after that, you can call the shots. So that is my first suggestion. And second question, yes, Salesforce, we have a very good thriving developer ecosystem in India for Salesforce, but mostly we work for international projects outside India. That is mainly because of the cost factor, for sure. We are rated a little highly than our competitors, which are Sugar, Zoho, CRM, Microsoft, Dynamics, etc. That will slowly change because Salesforce will definitely think about touching the mid-segment market of India. I'll not really be able to comment much on that, but definitely because majority of it has got to do with the cost, not with the effectiveness or the efficiency of the program, efficiency of the product, because Salesforce as a product is really advanced, right? Thank you. In the community, a big round of applause to Nisha. I think she has joined later in this session. Welcome Nisha to India Dreaming.
So, in Ahmedabad, we have organized a couple of
workshops. Yes. Congratulations for that.
So, but challenge that we are facing is, we are not able to cater students early. When the student crowd is more, we struggle to get them.
Okay.
How can we actually overcome that?
So, you want to scale with a bigger number of students?
Yes.
Okay.
And some training on how to manage them.
Okay.
So it's really hard for us to manage the crowd when we are doing the hands-on training, or especially the challenges is when we do the hands-on training.
Nishi, it would really help if you come with us to the workshop that we conduct in India. We have struggled in the initial stages like you. We have slowly evolved as a team and saw what the challenges would really help if you can come with us. I would invite you. Please come down to one of our workshops and be one of our volunteers and see how it is working. And definitely I will help you with that. Don't worry about it.
Guys, come and conduct a workshop in Ahmedabad so that we have a group of 6 to 7 courses.
Okay.
So that we can actually learn from you how
sure.
to you conduct, and then that we can carry forward that idea.
We are waiting for an invitation.
Okay. And make sure that
absolutely.